absolutely amazing that the parents and just the reaction from everyone around, this isn't like all the other shootings. And although we all pray for those families and we all feel for them the same that we are feeling, this is different and change is gonna come now. And I want you guys to remember, this is never going to happen again like this. No more families won't have their kids at home anymore. No more families will have to fear about their kids going to school. If there's one thing I want you guys to remember, is that you guys are why this is happening. Your reaction, the things you are doing, your tweets, your words, your emotions, that's what's keeping me motivated. Also, the families and the kids we lost, that's what's motivating me every single day to keep going. You guys are absolutely amazing, and again, thank you for your time. Also, since we live in Florida, this is a very strong Hispanic community. I'd like to say some words in Spanish as well.
Hola a todos, soy Alfonso Calderón y quiero decir algo. Es mi placer, por favor, poder hablar en español a toda la gente que está aquí. Florida es el estado de la gente hispana y latina y toda la gente que habla español en el alrededor del mundo. La familia es lo que más importa en esta sociedad. Y nuestras familias van a estar seguras después de que venga un poquito de cambio con todos nuestros esfuerzos. Va a ser increíble poder hablar con los políticos y los legisladores de Florida y después algún día del país. Muchísimas gracias.
So I want everybody to remember, this is the March for Our Lives. This is not just in America. This is in France. This is in every country in Europe, every country in Africa, Asia, South America. This movement is changing everything, and it needs to change now. Thank you.
So what did you think when you got off the bus? You see all these kids from a city you've never been to, these kids who don't know you guys, are all out here. What did you think of this reception?
Leon High School, Leon County kids. Real quick, a lot of times when you go to a friend or a loved one's house and someone's passed away, it's really awkward. You don't know what to say, and all you can do is kind of hug them and shed a tear with them and let them know how much you love them. You just delivered that message.
Wow.
Tell us your name.
It shows you how proud I am of you. Okay, your time is, you're all in this together.
He said it really quickly.
Have a voice. You do have a voice. A lot of times people talk to me about kids today, and they're not the same. They're right. You are so much better than the students that I was here in this school with 35 years ago. And I am so proud of you. I just can't stand it. I mean, you sent a message tonight, not only to these kids that you are marching with and marching beside them, and at some point, something has to change. And I love you all from the bottom of my heart. And I can't thank you enough for what you've done.
Are we done?
cutting it, Ed had just imploded at 9:50.
Slide my sticks down to me. If you would, please. Thank you.
I don't fall on my ass.
No, don't. Yeah, you don't have to come down right here. I got this second presser.
Great.
Okay. And the kid was really good, the last kid that spoke.
And they're going to try and go in and get something.
They got him after the presser. I saw Chris there. But I got the presser.
Yeah, that's great.
I had a mic up there.
All right.
So I don't need to know if you need to look at that at some point. The sound card, it's at about 9.
Wait, is there stuff up in the car?
21, between 2150 and 2155, 56. And what do you think about the live background?
Oh, good, okay.
Yeah, the second of three buses filled with Parkland students just pulled up here in Tallahassee at this local high school. They started their day with funerals for their friends that they lost just last week, and then a 400-mile trip to be here tonight. The local students, though, gave them a big, warm welcome here. Many plan to actually rally alongside the Parkland teens tomorrow. It's pretty simple. They want gun control. They're expected to lead a massive rally tomorrow morning on the Capitol steps to demand just that. But already their battle is looking tough. The state house today voting down a motion to simply talk about a bill banning assault rifles. That was a 36-71 vote with some of those Parkland survivors who got here early in the crowd for the vote. Those arriving, though, not seemed fazed tonight, telling the local students they're here to fight for their friends. They're here to fight for students everywhere. Many saying tonight that they don't plan to give up until there is change on this one. Now, those students will stay the night here in a local civic center near the Florida State campus, also right next to the Capitol at that point. They will be then out early tomorrow to make that march on the Capitol. We will be live with them on Good Day Orlando, and we'll have their message for you tomorrow throughout the day here on Fox 35. For now, we're live in Tallahassee. I'm Brian Scott, Fox 35 News. Cool. No problem. Okay.
Separate things all in one roll. We're going to do his look lives for 11, and then I'm going to feed you raw footage for the 11 right after that. Okay. Go.
All right. 3, 2. And you can see a lot of students still continuing to linger outside of Leon High School here, meeting with the 3, 2. And you can see a lot of students still lingering outside of Leon High School here in Tallahassee, meeting with